Hello once again, time for another Jubilant Saturday Daily Devo. For Saturday, August the 21st, 2021, and episode number... Hey, I forgot to say episode number yesterday. Oops. I'm sorry. So yesterday's episode was 452. Today's is 453. I'm sorry about that. I just realized I did not say episode in that one. I am so sorry, but you see it in the title, so I'm just so sorry I forgot to say it. But yesterday was 452. Today is 453. Sorry about that. Sorry. I forgot to say the episode yesterday. And I just realized it because I just recorded that video just a little while ago, so I forgot to say it. So. Today, we are going to be sealed by the Holy Spirit. This is, looks like a regular Devo. We're going to begin with Ephesians 1, 13 and 14. Smash that like button at the end of the video. Comment what you liked about it. Hit that subscribe button if you're new. Hit that notification bell where you never missed another video. When you know when my videos go live. Share the video with your family and friends and help me reach that goal of 1,000 subscribers, which is at $9.95 to go as of recording these videos today. So, I trust you'll help me out by doing that, and I'll appreciate it. So, without further ado, let's see what Sealed by the Holy Spirit has to offer, or has to teach us today. Ephesians 1, 13 and 14. In whom ye also trusted, after that ye heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, in whom also after that ye believed, ye were sealed with that Holy Spirit of promise, which is the earnest of our inheritance, unto the redemption of the purchased possession, until the praise of his glory. Okay. So from very ancient times, it has been the custom to confirm and guarantee an agreed on purchase by sealing the contract with a seal that could only be broken by the buyer when he was ready to take possession of his purchase. So that marvelous transaction seen by John at God's throne in heaven was in reference to this practice. Because only the Lamb is found worthy to open the seven seal scroll on which is recorded the title of the whole creation. And oh yes, I did shave IRL today. So today, Thursday, I had to go wash some certain areas, and I decided to go ahead and shave before I got in there so I can rinse some hair off of me. So, looks pretty good, don't it? I clean up nice, but when I just let it go, it's like, man, I'm getting dirty. Need to clean up. I told you the other day I was going to clean up. I said I need to clean up. Maybe next time I'll be clean by the time I do the next video run. So here it is. Okay. Revelation 5:9 says, and they sung a new song, saying, thou art worthy to take the scroll and to open the seals thereof, for thou wast slain and hast redeemed us to God by thy blood. So the purchase price had been paid on Calvary. The resurrected Lamb had come to claim his possession. So we are part of that possession. Amen? So the price had been paid for our redemption from sin's bondage, but we have not yet inherited, we have not yet entered on the inheritance which our great Redeemer has promised us. So in the meantime, our individual title deed, as it were, has been sealed by none other than the Holy Spirit, as in the title. He is not only the seal, but also the earnest, that is the down payment, the earnest money, who guarantees the total redemption of the purchased possession. Amen? So his personal presence in our lives is our assurance that the full promise will be fulfilled. And we are urged to, Ephesians 4:30, grieve not, the Holy Spirit of God, whereby ye were sealed unto the day of redemption. And then lastly, he, 2 Corinthians 1:22, hath also sealed us, and given the earnest of the Spirit in our hearts. Amen? So that's all I have for your Jubilant Saturday Days of Praise Devo, the one and only video today. So, trust you enjoyed that, and I'll give you normally I would do the preview of the turning point, but there's no turning point today because that one is not till tomorrow. But tomorrow we're going to be in the next The mini-series video. We just had one yesterday, and we'll have one again tomorrow for Sunday, which I think that's going to be 21. So, for Sunday, August the 22nd, episode 454, we're going to be talking about the face of Jesus Christ, starting with 2 Corinthians 4, verse number 6. We trust you stay tuned for that. I'll get to that in just a little bit. And your preview, I'm going to give you your verses and everything for the weekend, but I will give you an update. This weekend Devo for your turning point, for episode 19, it's going to be way off now, for your 21st and 22nd. So for your Saturday and Sunday, August 21st and 22nd weekend, this is weekend number 4 of the 5. In the Forget Me Not series, we're going to be talking about in the face of fear. You remember we started out in the face of the unknown. Then we went to in the face of responsibilities. Then last weekend we had the face of abundance. This weekend we've got in the face of fear. And then the last weekend, we'll have in the face of need, the last weekend of the month. And then, like I said, the new weekend series for September will be Season of Living. So, I'm just going to give you that one. It'll be just set up just like this one. Just set up just like I do on this one. So, and your recommended reading for tomorrow's turning point, we're going to read Psalm 94, 12 through 14. We're going to begin with Psalm 27, verse 9, the beginning verse. William Gurnell will be the turning point. And your daily reading is Jeremiah 51 through Lamentations 2. So, I trust you go ahead and read Jeremiah 51 and 52 today. Finish up Jeremiah. And then go over and read tomorrow sometime. Read Lamentations 1 and 2 because that's it, 4 chapters. Go ahead and split them up between the 2 days, and you'll be able to do your daily Bible reading if you're following along with this Bible reading. But I'll get to those in just a few minutes. I'll get them while I'm in this run. But trust you'll stay tuned. I love you and I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. keep on keeping on and trusting God, and He'll keep you safe. But until tomorrow, everybody, peace out. Until then. Goodbye. God bless. Have a wonderful and jubilant Saturday, wherever you are. And come back again tomorrow for another Lord's Day double feature. Goodbye.